The topic for today's discussion is aseptic inoculation. This is in continuation to our topic on sterilization of fermenters, which we discussed in the previous class of how to sterilize fermenter, how to sterilize media and air supply sterilization. Basically, we have studied about two types of sterilization, that is using heat or steam and using filtration. So these were the most prominent methods of sterilization. And one more thing that has to be highlighted here is sterilization can be done, for example, media. If you want to sterilize media, if you sterilize the entire media, for example, 10,000 liters of media in one stretch, if you want to sterilize it in one time sterilization, you want to do, you call it as batch sterilization. Suppose this media is supplied into the tank regularly means 5,000 liters you will supply today. Then you will be supplying 1,000 liters every day. It is called as continuous fermentation, wherein we will supply media continuously. Then we have to do something called as continuous sterilization. So there are two types of sterilization, also based on whether you do it in one time or whether you do it in a periodical time. So when you do it in one stretch, we call it as batch sterilization, and if you do it as a continuous process, we call it as continuous sterilization. So difference here is batch sterilization, because you are doing it in one stretch, one time, it is lower capital cost. Capital cost means the money you put for sterilization is at one stretch. So it is, you can note down the points if you want. We call it as lower capital cost, batch sterilization. First point. Second point is lower equipment cost. Means only one equipment is required and that has to be sterilized along with media. And third point is lower risk of contamination. When you do sterilization at one stretch, contamination problem is also minimized. Fourth point is feasibility for high viscous medium. Whenever your media is very thick, having lot of solid material, that time batch sterilization is more preferred. So there are four good thing about batch sterilization, that is lower capital cost, low equipment cost, lower risk of contamination, and feasible for high viscous medium. And if you look at continuous sterilization, that also has some good properties. For example, continuous sterilization leads to, first point is superior medium quality. The media will be of good quality when you do continuous sterilization, because you are doing it in intervals, little you sterilize it, you will do it superior medium quality. Second point is scale up is easy. Scale up means, I will explain to you what it is later. Scale up is easier there. And next is automated control. So when you are doing continuous sterilization, everything can be automated, so no need of manual input. So that is one advantage. And the fourth point is less corrosion of fermenter. When you are doing continuous sterilization, corrosion property is less than doing it in a whole, instead of doing it as a batch. Continuous sterilization has these four advantages, that is superior medium quality, scale up is easier, automated control, and less corrosion of fermenter. So this is about sterilization. As I told you for today's PPT, we are discussing about aseptic inoculation. Aseptic inoculation means how to inoculate microorganisms. See, this is in this industry we are using microorganism. Based on microorganism, fermentation takes place. So when you are inoculating the microorganism into the fermenter, we call it as inoculation. You all know it. What is inoculation? So this is not inoculating something. It is not like your lab where you take one loofful of culture and inoculate into a test tube. It is something like you are inoculating microorganism into 10,000 liter media, or inoculating it into 50,000 or 1 lakh liter medium. So inoculation also will be such an important event here, because inoculation means you are inoculating the organism. And during that process, if you are not maintaining aseptic condition, it may lead to contamination. So as you can see in the slide, why we have to do aseptic inoculation during fermentation is for two reasons. One is to prevent contamination. Another one is to prevent escape of the process organism. That means the organism what we are using is called process organism. It should not escape. So one is contamination, one is prevent its escape into the environment. First point, if you see, to prevent contamination, why we have to prevent contamination is because of contamination, productivity will be lost. That means yield, whatever yield you wanted, you will be losing the yield. That is why we call it as loss of productivity if contamination happens. Second thing is contaminant outgrow. Sometimes your contaminating organism will overgrow, especially during continuous fermentation process. Your contaminating organism may overgrow your the required organism. That also is a huge problem in the industries. Third thing is undesirable byproducts. Contaminating organism will produce undesirable products, byproducts, which will hinder your product. Along with your product, some other undesirable products will be there. It is a problem. And fourth important point is your product also may sometimes get degraded. For example, I'll give you one classical example. You are producing an antibiotic. Let us hope your organism is producing an antibiotic. Suppose the contaminating organism is producing a resistant compound to your antibiotic. What will happen is that resistant compound will come, for example, a resistant compound can break down penicillin. For example, you are producing penicillin in large scale. Suppose the contaminating organism is producing a compound which can break down penicillin. In that case, what will happen is your yield will become reduced and you may not get healed also. Why? Because the contaminating organism is breaking down your product. That is called degradation of desirable product. That is one example I gave you. One next point is contamination can lead to loss of product recovery. Product recovery becomes difficult. That means you cannot recover your product. Your contaminating organism is producing some pigment. That pigment will give color to your compound. That is also a big problem, recovery problem. So this is for all these things we should see that we do aseptic inoculation. Next thing is to prevent escape of organism into the environment. See, that is also very, very important. Suppose your organism is genetically engineered organism you are using in the industry, you have already studied containment protocols. Please remember that containment levels are there based on, if your organism is genetically engineered, and moreover if it is a pathogenic organism, that is harmful organism, and genetically engineered organism means containment level B3, B4, like that it is there. So you have to follow all these containment levels while doing aseptic inoculation. So let us see few diagrams. These diagrams you have to draw in the exam to explain how aseptic inoculation is done to the fermenter. You can see in this diagram, just observe at right hand corner, bottom, you can see plant, that is fermenter, is there. Full fermenter is not drawn in this diagram, just it is shown partially a part of the fermenter. So what is entering into the fermenter here is the, you can see the pipeline connected to a small cylindrical apparatus. It contains microorganisms. See, our topic is aseptic inoculation. That means 1 lakh liter or 10,000 liter medium is there. You have to inoculate your organism. You cannot inoculate one loo full of organism. You have to inoculate 1000 ml culture or 5000 ml medium. You have to inoculate containing microorganisms. So you can see in that cylindrical vessel, what is present is your microorganism. What you have to do is you have to inoculate that microorganism into the huge fermenter. For that, you can see various pipelines are laid. Through these pipelines, the organism will be inoculated into fermenter. So there is no manual work here. Everything is automated, but the pipelines should be sterile. So this is called level B1. For those industry which do level B1 containment, for them, they will follow this type of flow chart and they will follow this setup only. B1 means GILSP, good industrial large scale practice. So you can see here, first what they will do is, can you see their A and B valve, very important, A valve, B valve. It is together in the diagram, you can see the pipeline AB. So till microorganism is inoculated, A will be the end point. That is, A will be closed. You can see below it is given A. A will be closed with a plug. The small letter A, you can see, that is called a plug. So it is closing plug. So this setup will not be there until you are doing inoculation. Whenever you are doing inoculation, from the fermenter, near the A port, that A plug is there. Small letter A, you can see that plug is there, and that will be the end point of the pipeline. This microbial the culture, the inoculum, the vessel, you can see, that will be separately placed in one more room, and it is called as B is the end B, it is plugged with B, small letter B, you can see it is plugged. Whenever your media is fermenter is ready and whenever you want to do inoculation, you have to take this setup, that is your B containing the inoculum, and you have to open the plug, small letter B plug is there, that you have to open aseptically. The other side A is there, small letter A, that plug you have to remove, and this capital letter A and capital letter B is there, no? Those two points has to be interconnected. When you connect it, the inoculum is connected to fermenter. That setup is done. So before you do the connections, you have to open the steam, F you have to open. Before you connect A to B, you have to open the F, you have to open, and you have to leave the steam, and you have to open E. And that pipeline should be sterilized. Once the pipeline is sterilized, then you connect the A and B. Once A and B is connected, you can see inoculum is ready and the entire pipeline is sterile. Now you open C. When you open C, what happens? C is air supply. With high pressure, air will be supplied. And D is the, what you call it as, the membrane. Sterile air will be, the air will get filtered through the membrane and this air will enter into the inoculum. When it enters into the inoculum, what happens is it will push the medium. So pressure is put on the medium, that is on the inoculum, pressure is put, air will put pressure. So when pressure is put, you can see the diagram there, when pressure is put into the medium, because of this pressure, the inoculum will travel through the pipeline. Through B, A, it will travel. E, through valve E, it will travel. You have to open the valve E. You have to close the valve F when you are passing the medium, because media should not enter into the steam supply. When you close F and open E, and when you put pressure on C and D, what happens is the inoculum will flow via E. It will flow into the fermenter. So the process what is done here is to see that the inoculum is aseptically supplied into the fermenter. So we call it as good industrial large scale practice, or we call it as GILSP. Okay, and there are three more diagrams which deals with how at different containment levels how aseptically media can be transferred into the vessel. I think for three more slides time may not be enough. I will just stop with this slide. I will be making one more PPT with the same slide setup to finish the remaining three or four slides.